there at the end of the runway is Concord 001, and in Toulouse has joined Raymond Baxter.
Just seconds to go.
Et maintenant, enfin, le premier vol.
110 tons of aircraft, all up, wait there. The magic moment with us. The crescendo sound from the 593 Olympuses.
Ce premier vol que vous tous allez voir maintenant en direct.
45 knots, 90, 135.
Nose come up to 20 degrees, she's airborne. She flies.
The Concorde was special. The quality of the work, the minds, the skill, the talent, the commitment that went into it, that's what really matters.
Over the last 27 years, Concorde has captured the imagination of people from all over the world. An extraordinary feat of engineering, a unique blend of power, grace, and beauty.
First time I've ever been that near. Never driven going in because I'm retired.
I am thrilled. Every single cell in my body is thrilled.
Words fail me, so incredible. Wonderful experience.
What are you going to tell your school friends when you get back to school on Monday?
Well, trying to find some way of getting them to believe me.
Morning.
Welcome aboard.
Welcome to Concorde and our supersonic operation from London's Heathrow to New York's John F. Kennedy. Here we are, ladies and gentlemen. We're through Mark 1. The speed of sound, no bumps, no bangs. Concorde.
There's the view of New York from the Triborough Bridge. There's the Sydney Opera House. And there's Concorde, arguably the three most beautiful man-made sites in the world.
We have carried the Queen Mother, world leaders, stars. It has been an amazing magnet.
Phil Collins had dashed from the Wembley stage to Philadelphia by helicopter and Concorde.
It's good fun. I mean, only a fool such as I would do this.
For 27 years, British Airways Concorde has been a national symbol, a natural centrepiece for celebration.
A few hundred feet over the heads of a million people, maybe more, Concorde and the Red Arrows fill the sky.
We flew down the Mall and you could see Her Majesty standing on the balcony. I've never seen a million people before, let alone them all looking up and waving and cheering for Concorde.
She's brought cities together, brought people closer, and reminded us all that we can do extraordinary things.
You kind of think, oh, I wonder who might be on Concorde, maybe famous film star who's just signed a contract in New York or something.
Catherine Zeta-Jones is an absolute star, so glamorous, so Hollywood. Paul McCartney is probably everyone's favourite. He will say hello and he remembers us. Oh, Richard Gere. I've loved him since I was about five.
You can always recognise it, and it looks like a swan. You know when swans fly? It looks like a swan with the shape of its neck.
It's the most brilliant example of far-sighted designers thought ahead and kept a lead for half a century.
No matter how many times you fly, there still is that amazing, exciting sensation when you take off.
Every day is a thrill. By the time the passengers come on board, the air is absolutely charged with excitement.
Speedboat Concorde 1, you're clear for takeoff. 27 left, surface wind, 240 at 10.
Speedboat Concorde 1, roger, clear for takeoff, 27 left.
It's a thrill. It's the nearest thing I'll ever feel to a rocket.
How starts to bite, push back into your seat.
Airspeed's building.
You're concentrating like mad.
60 knots.
The noise takes over.
100 knots. That's it.
Heart starts to pound a bit.
V1. Rotate. V2. Positive climb.
For 27 years, she has been our flagship, and her inspiration will stay with us as we take our standards of service still higher and higher.